有什么问题？
Now, this one's fresh, but four preseason games in the books. Where would you say the team stands now with the regular season, the next thing up for you guys?
I mean, we're still, you know, trying to determine rotations and, you know, combinations, and it's really what I expected. And, you know, I think in general, it's going to take a little bit of time, a little while to get into a rhythm, as it should. And I think that the guys' effort and their attitude is incredible. I think that this trip brought us together, and I'm really excited to coach this team.
刚刚问题问到，七六人已经完成了四场的季前热身赛，问到教练觉得，球队现在是站在一个什么样的位置来迎接常规赛的来临？教练觉得他们还是在尝试去决定他们的一个轮换的阵容，包括各种不同的组合，这个也是他在预料当中会发生的事。基本上说，他们还是一步一步的来，用多一点的时间来让球队进入一个非常好的节奏。他非常欣赏自己的球员，非常努力，而且他们的意向方向是非常好的，特别是在参加这次的 NBA 中国赛，让整队更加团结，他觉得这个是让他们球队更好去迎接本赛季的常规赛。
What's up, Brett? Keith Pompey. Brett, was starting JJ in the second half a product of Markel being in foul trouble, or was it the thing in regards to the rotation you're talking about? You're still trying to figure out rotations.
For me, it was the thing that we're going to try to pursue in rotation. It didn't have anything to do with Markel being in foul trouble. And part of my responsibility is to be able to put these guys in environments, you know, with different combinations, and try to figure that out as quickly as I'm able. And I believe that Markel is at his best with the ball. And so when you watch how I substitute and determine patterns, when you can bring him off the bench in the second half, you're able to get him like four or five more minutes as a point guard. And I believe it's something that we will continue to look at, and it was done for that reason.
刚刚有记者问到关于雷迪克在下半场的作为首发，会不会是因为富尔兹他的各犯缠身，还是说他要好像刚刚教练说要尝试新的轮换制度？他说，其实他们在那么短的时间内，作为教练，他希望能够以尽短的时间来给球队有更多组合的机会，而并不是因为富尔兹有各犯的缠身，所以在下半场没有把他派上场。而且他觉得富尔兹他在控球方面更加独到，所以在球赛上面这样子的调配也是他在寻找更好的轮换的其中的一个机会以及方案。
Brett, with all that said, are you still going to stick with Markel in the starting lineup?
I am.
And okay, to start games?
I am.
刚刚问题是他会不会还是继续用富尔兹来打首发？他说应该会。应该是会的。
Brett, kind of a follow-up on that, just having a full preseason to evaluate him, what was your take on Markel and kind of his progress at this point?
I mean, it's really what I expected. He's 20 years old, it's the NBA, you know, and you're going to see up and down. And I think the best thing for me is the fact that he is a willing defender. He lets us coach him. I think that he's shown improvement and tremendous heart, picking up other ball carriers, other point guards. And I think that we're all, you know, going to have to step back and be realistic and / patient with a 20-year-old's growth.
刚刚问到教练有一个完整的
季前热身赛来评估一下福尔斯他在季前热身赛的表现。他觉得他是预料当中福尔斯有这么样的表现，因为福尔斯现在只有20岁，刚进了 NBA 没多久，肯定是会有高低起伏的时刻。最好的一部分就是他看到福尔斯是一个非常好的防守者，而且也让他作为教练很愿意被教练去调配，而且他也看到福尔兹的成长，而且特别在控球后卫这个位置上面，现在的担当已经不少，可能我们大家都要退一步来真实的去看待这位新人，而且也可以说是要多一点耐性来看待福尔兹。
What did you make of the preseason Joel had?
I mean, I believe when you watch what he's doing, and he's had a summer of health.And he's had a preseason of health, that there are signs of dominance. And where I get most excited is his leadership and his maturity have been excellent. Our practices, as an example, here in China, were very good because our best players came to play.And Joel's attitude, along with his health and performance, is a tremendous package to start the season.
最后一个问题，记者问到，对于这一次的今年的季前热身赛怎么评价恩比德？他说，其实大家也看到恩比德做得非常好，包括整个夏天也是保持健康。而且在季前热身赛也是保持有健康的状态来上阵，大家可以看到他的体型再加上他在场上的征服力是非常高的，他也非常期待看到他其实非常兴奋看到恩比德现在打得越来越成熟，包括在队里面的领袖才华得到非常好的发挥，特别是大家看到他在中国的时候来到在练球的时候表现也非常不错，他最开心能够看到我们队中最棒的球员能够真的全力以赴来参加季前热身赛，所以健康再加上他的表现将会让恩比德越来越好。
The Philadelphia 76ers would very much like to thank the fans in the city of Shenzhen.We had a fantastic time in China. Shanghai and Shenzhen were incredibly hospitable, and we very much appreciate your hospitality and support. Thank you very much.
教练最后想要代表76人感谢我们深圳市，特别感谢他们在这一次的中国赛有非常好的旅途，包括在上海以及深圳，也感谢大家的款待，非常感谢你们，他们非常享受这一次的中国赛的经验，谢谢你们。